This is called grapes and apparatus, and with the help of grapes and apparatus you can verify law of parallelogram which you have studied in chapter 3, that when two forces are acting at certain angle, then resultant is given by diagonal of parallelogram. What you have to do, these two weights which are suspended here, first check whether these are in the same plane or not. That you can mark with the help of a scale. This is going little lower, so we shift this here. Almost same now. Let's check with the node. Mark this pencil one point here at this node. First check an equilibrium. How do you check the equilibrium of a system? These all weights stable, no weight should vibrate, no air is influencing. Make sure about it. Just push it up little bit gently and release it. Mark the point again. If it returns back at the same point, you see it has come back at the same point. Or a little bit around, that is also possible. Because of the friction, if friction in the pulley is little larger, the point might deviate. So now your system is in equilibrium. Now you have to proceed. How to proceed? Place a mirror strip to identify the direction of the forces clearly. Keep it at the center. Mark, look at straight on this mirror. Mark this side of the thread. Because one tension is acting this way, mark this side of the thread, left hand side. Another tension is acting this way because of the weight, and this third which is hanging at the middle center. Now move this strip little up straight without moving left and right, and bring node right at the corner of this mirror strip. Once it comes to the edge of the mirror strip, mark this node point also. So observation point is, as far as concern, is over. Now you have see 4 points on the white sheet. When we join these 2 points, this will give you the direction of force acting along, tension acting along this string. When you join this point, this will give you the direction of force or tension acting along this string. And these 2 points will give you the direction of force acting downward. So draw a parallelogram by choosing a scale. And after drawing parallelogram, join diagonal of the parallelogram and check it whether this is equal to 70 grams or not. Right now we have kept 70 grams here. Right? If there is any angle deviation in the angle of the resultant, that is also because of the force of friction. So Gravesend apparatus can also be used to find the weight of unknown mass body, unknown weight body. You, instead of this known weight at the center, you can suspend that block whose weight is unknown. Keep these two pens in a same level, place same weight, check the equilibrium. If system is not in equilibrium, then increase the weight on the sideways again and check it again until the system comes in equilibrium. Once the system comes in equilibrium, follow the same steps. You will mark 4 points. Join these 2 points and this will be the weight for the unknown body. Draw a parallelogram, find the resultant theoretically by choosing appropriate scale, and from this scale you can calculate the magnitude of mass of unknown body. Mass or weight of unknown body, both can be calculated because there is only a difference of g. So rest of the part, for the rest of part you can remove it. Right, remove this sheet from here and do it normal way. See now how to draw parallelogram. I am telling you the method here. We have already discussed on Gravesend experiments and marked 4 points here. So I am choosing a scale. As I told you, first choose an appropriate scale. And the scale which I am taking is 1 centimeter is equal to 20 grams. Right, so this was 70 grams, this was 70 grams, so the length of the line segment will be 3.5. So 3.5 we will mark in the same direction. This is the point marked 3.5, and 3.5 centimeter I will mark in the same direction from here. It is 3.5 centimeter in this direction. You see, so joining these two points, this was also 70 grams. This is 3.5, check it again. So making it little darker for you. How to make parallelogram after this? Draw parallel line to this line segment. Draw parallel line to this line. Now your O, I think this is little tilted. This line has gone little, okay. So this is parallel, this is here, making it little darker. So this is the diagonal. Check the diagonal, it comes out around 4. However, practically you can check how much it should be, 3.5, because you are using 70 gram each. So from law of parallelogram, your formula is resultant magnitude is equal to square root of P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. Theta is an angle between these two line segment, that is 120, right? So 120 means 70 grams whole square, 70 grams whole square plus 2 into 70 into 70. Cos 120 is minus 1/2, so this cancels. This comes out 170 square gets cancelled because minus is coming here. So your answer is 70 grams, and according to the scale, the length of the diagonal should be 3.5 centimeter. So I think this line, these two lines are not parallel, so I rub it little more for you. This line doesn't seem parallel to this. Let us check making it parallel to this line. First, this is the parallel line here, so this must go like this. Fine, this is parallel line here, joining these two points parallel to this. Now diagonal is this. You see the diagonal is almost same length. This is 3.6. There is little variation in this because of the friction between the pulley and the thread. This is 120 grams, so when you measure, it is 3.6 centimeter into 20 grams, that comes out 72 grams. So there is an error of measurement of 2 grams because of the frictional force. That's how you will verify law of parallelogram. But if you want to measure the weight of the body, so these you can keep 70, 70, 100, 100, whatever you choose. Draw the figure for parallelogram, find the length of the diagonal, and then calculate from your scale, you will get the weight of unknown body.